वेलकम टू एनएमई आईसीटी साक्षर ई कंटेंट प्रोजेक्ट अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट। द प्रोजेक्ट इज अंडर एनएमई आईसीटी, दैट इज नेशनल मिशन ऑन एजुकेशन थ्रू इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। अंडर दिस मिशन अ प्रॉपर बैलेंस बिटवीन कंटेंट जनरेशन, research in critical areas relating to imparting of education and connectivity for integrating our knowledge with the advancement in other countries is to be attempted. In order to bolster our knowledge resources to obtain and maintaining the competitive edge in the world, we require a system of identification and nurturing of talent and lifelong learning. Knowledge modules based on personalized needs of the learner would need to be delivered to him or her at the right time with the right content interactively to take care of his or her aspirations. With these objectives in mind, these videos are created for the portal section. We will learn basic marketing over here.
Hi, I am LL means learner. I am learner of marketing management. I'll learn marketing in master's class. The desire for learning marketing comes out of interest. This is very interesting topic. Marketing management is seen everywhere in the society. You see up or down, you see here and there, you can see brand names and logos and advertisements and people working in marketing area. I am very much interested in learning marketing. Let us learn marketing from Dr. J. Badayani. He is going to teach marketing management under Sakshat e-Content Development Project under National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology, that means NMEICT. Let us start learning.
Good morning to all. Today, we are going to learn e-marketing.
Hello and welcome to Sakshat e-Content on Marketing Management. Today, we are going to understand e-marketing. E-marketing, that is electronic marketing, is a subset of e-business. That is what is electronic business. Electronic business utilizes the electronic medium to perform marketing activities. They achieve the desired marketing objectives for an organization through this electronic medium business. Well, internet marketing, interactive marketing, or mobile marketing, they are the examples for this e-marketing. It can be use of any electronic medium. Well, there are several advantages as well as disadvantages of electronic marketing. Advantages include reduction in cost through automation and use of electronic media. Well, obviously, when you look to electronic marketing or electronic business, you can see from one computer it goes to some server to another computer and comes back. In that process, the manufacturer or the marketer goes for direct marketing to consumers. It removes the middleman, I mean to say the wholesalers and the distributors and the retailers and whatnot. All middlemen, agents, brokers, wholesalers, retailers, distributors, dealers, they are removed in this process, and thus it is said as it reduces cost. Well, second point talks about faster responses to both marketer and end user. Like you say, I put a purchase intent over here and instantly within seconds the marketer comes to know that what I need. They can send it and the immediately my money from my bank account or my credit card or debit card or etc. It can be directly transferred to his account. I want to say within seconds the process gets over. Well, it goes for increased ability to measure and collect data. Well, when marketers are directly in contact with consumers, they can instantly gauge the minds of the consumer. They can instantly go to consumers and instantly ask them for what they need and want. So this is what is there. Another way, electronic behavior even can be measured. I mean to say, where I am clicking, when I am clicking, to what I am clicking, they come to know. Definitely, yes. Even the speech on mobile phones or the speech on telephones, they can measure. I mean to say, the emotions behind that speech, the objectives behind that speech can be measured easily. Well, next is open the possibility of market through personalization. They go for personalization. They ask the consumers that what you need and want exactly. It goes for one-to-one marketing or one-to-one advertising over here too. So you can say that it is very important that when marketer directly comes in contact with consumers, they can do wonders. Well, increased interactivity, instant response, instant asking and directly talking to marketers and consumers, they goes for increased interactivity, and again need satisfaction at both the ends will meet more successfully over here. So that is what is advantages. There may be many more advantages possible over here, but the major I have covered. Disadvantages of e-marketing includes lack of personal approach. Well, when we said personalized marketing is possible in advantages over here, we say that lack of personal approach. It depends on marketer that how much personal he wish to go. Normally, when you are e-marketing, you are marketing to globe. When you are marketing to the total globe, it is more general. If you don't interact with your individual customers, then it becomes very difficult to say that it is a personalized approach. Rather, it is more impersonalized approach. You talk about dependability on technology. Well, in our country, India, villages don't have electricity in general. When electricity is not there, how can you talk of computers, how can you talk of laptops or tablets or mobiles or even e-business? When more than one third of the mass cannot read what is written on the screen, what is the fun of e-marketing? Well, there are even security issues over here. Security of my money is always questionable when I am transacting through net, because net has got hackers as we have got thieves. Thieves can be in the house and hackers and crackers can be on internet. The money transfer is always a question when security is considered. When you talk about, you know, constantly changing technology, again the maintenance cost increases. Recall, before a decade we had got that huge CRT computers, that CRT to laptop, a recent change. A laptop to mobile, again a change. And mobile to tablets is again a change, which we are posing over here, which is a constant one. Now, tablets to where? We don't know. It will come soon. But if it is soon, what about the hardwares which I have purchased for e-marketing priorly? What about the cost on them? What about the maintenance on them? I'm sorry, the speed is increasing, blasting, expressing. But what about my devices which had got lesser speeds? The maintenance of them is very crucial, and it is, the cost is very high when we compare to traditional ways of business and traditional assets. Well, when we say higher transparency of pricing is there when we are talking of e-business, you have to show that what your prices are. And when prices are transparent, there are all chances that price war and price competition takes place. When price competition takes place, well, the margins are lowering down. And when margins are lowering down, well, manufacturers are even mankind. Several times they may not hesitate to take wrong ways to degrade the quality even. Cheating of consumers, taking different names, fake products, security of monetary transaction, etc., etc., poses many questions to electronic marketing, specifically in India. Well, that's what about advantages and disadvantages. But we say in general terms, an e-marketing strategy consists of the steps taken and procedures followed for marketing a brand through the web, i-marketing, or through mobile, m-marketing, or through tablets, we can say t-marketing. Well, that's what is something in electronic marketing. But over here, the center of attraction in any e-marketing strategy is the website of the organization. If website is much more simple, consumers are much more attracted. It must be simple and attractive. Something like, let's say, taking an example, you go to google.com or co.in and you will find out that it's very easy to search. The cursor will be placed over there only where Google is written and you can type directly. It's not something very clumsy and there are not thousands of logo which are appearing on the page and you are lost where to go. No, sir. You take any example of any good websites and you will find out that it will be very easy, categorized, classified, and you will find out where you would like to go. You take the example of Amazon.com, or in India you take the example of Flipkart, or you take the example of Naptol, or you take the example of Rediff. Well, this e-business is upcoming. The growth is rising. It goes somewhere where digital technologies will take place the traditional business, but with cautions, with limitations, or we say disadvantages. We have to keep that in our mind and we have to be careful. This is what is about e-marketing. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the class and watching. I have learned a lot. Did you? Have a good day from the learner.